Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain about IUPAC nomenclature for heterocyclic compounds. But before watching this video, I will strongly recommend you to watch my previous videos on IUPAC nomenclature. Link of those videos or playlist is given in the description as well as here in the I button. Now coming to the IUPAC nomenclature for heterocyclic compound. So it can be done by three methods. First one is Hans-Widemann nomenclature. Second one is common name, and third one is replacement nomenclature. So coming to the first one, that is Hans-Widemann nomenclature.
This video is sponsored by Pharmacy India app. They provide online test series for competitive exams related to pharmacy like GPAT, Drugs Inspector, NIPER, previous year question papers, pharmacist and all. Download dedicated Pharmacy India app for complete details. Link is given in the description.
So in this video, first I will explain about Hans-Widemann nomenclature because it is widely used nomenclature system. And after that, I will discuss the details about common names and replacement nomenclature. So what is Hans-Widemann nomenclature? So let's take an example for a better understanding of this Hans-Widemann nomenclature. So this nomenclature is basically based on three things. First one is type of heteroatom, which is here denoted by Z. Second one is size of the ring, which is here denoted by N. And the third one is type of the ring, means it is saturated or unsaturated. So this nomenclature is mainly based on the type of the heteroatom, which is Z, and here heteroatom mostly used heteroatoms are nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus and sulfur. Second one is size of the ring. So this nomenclature is only applicable for those ring system which are having 3 to 10 membered atoms. And the third parameter is nature of the ring, whether ring is saturated or unsaturated. So coming to the prefixes used for this type of the heteroatoms, means Z. So these are the heteroatoms which are commonly used, and according to their priority order. So if oxygen will be present, then prefix used for oxygen will be oxa. If sulfur will be present, then prefix used for sulfur will be thia. If nitrogen will be present, then prefix used for nitrogen will be aza. If phosphorus will be used or phosphorus will be present, then prefix will be phospho. Now coming to nature of the ring. So according to the nature of the ring, these are classified into two types. First one is saturated and second one is unsaturated. If saturated ring will be present, then suffix ane will be used. And if unsaturated ring will be present, then suffix ine, means in, or only e will be used. If partial unsaturation will be present, then I will discuss those examples in the later part. Now coming to the second parameter, that is size of the ring. So size of the ring based root words will be used. It will be some specific root words. So first I will make a table for this one for better understanding. So this is the table. In first column we will take ring size. In second column we will take suffix. In third column we will take saturated part. In fourth column we will take unsaturated part, and in this column we will take few nitrogen containing saturated part. So here ring size will be, as it is written here, 3 to 10. So it will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now coming to the suffix. So for better understanding of suffix, let's take a mnemonics, and that is erythrol in epoch on EC. So you have to remember this mnemonic, that is erythrol in epoch on EC. Now let's take two alphabets for each suffix. So first suffix for three membered ring will be IR, then ET, then OL, then IN, then EP, then OC, then ON, then EC. Now coming to the saturated heterocyclic compound. So if it will be saturated, then IR plus ANE suffix will be added and it will be irene. So it will be irene. Similarly, it will be written like this: ET, OL, IN, EP, OC, ON, EC. Then we will add ANE. So it will be etane, olane, inane, epane, osane, onane, and ekane. Now coming to the unsaturated compound. So similarly, first we will write these suffix. So it will be IR, ET, OL, IN, EP, OC, ON, EC. Now coming to the suffix for these unsaturated compounds. So either we have to use INE or we have to use E. So in the case of IR, we will use INE. So it will be irene. Left these 3, 4, 5 and 6 membered heterocycles. Then next take the 7th one. And it will be epine, osine, onine and ekane. Now coming to these 3. So here another suffix word will be used, that is E. So it, ol and in. So this will be the suffix for unsaturated compound. Now coming to the saturated with nitrogen atom. So for saturated with nitrogen atom is an exception for 3, 4 and 5 membered rings. So some common names are used for these examples and it will be like this. So three membered saturated nitrogen atom containing heterocyclic ring will be known as iridine. Similarly, four membered will be etidine and five membered will be olidine, and remaining 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 member will follow these rules. Now coming to the rules for nomenclature. So coming to the first rule. So first rule is that name the heterocycle by combining prefix or prefixes with appropriate root word. So here we will use this prefix and we will combine with this suffix or this suffix according to the condition. Now coming to the second rule. So as per this statement, the letter A may be omitted from the prefix. So when we will combine this prefix and this suffix, then we can remove this A. All prefix contains A, so we can remove this A. For example, if you are taking oxa and irene, then it will be oxirene. Now coming to the third rule. So as per this statement, saturated and unsaturated suffix applies only to the completely saturated and unsaturated rings respectively. So these suffixes are used only if our compound is completely saturated or it is completely unsaturated. So what happens if it is partially saturated or partially unsaturated? In that case, we have to go through the rule 4. So as per this fourth statement, appropriate prefix such as dihydro, trihydro, tetrahydro, etc. should be used for partially unsaturation by using the root word of unsaturated ring. Now let's take some examples for better understanding of these rules. So these are the examples, and we have to give IUPAC nomenclature for this ring system. So coming to this one, so here it contains nitrogen, so prefix will be aza, and it contains 6 membered ring and it is completely saturated. So go to the 6 membered ring and it is completely saturated, so it will be known as enane. So enane. Now here, as per this second rule, the letter A may be omitted from the prefix. So we will omit this A and the complete name will be aginane. Now let's go to this example. So it is completely unsaturated and again it contains nitrogen. So prefix will be aza. Now coming to the 6 membered ring and unsaturated. 6 membered ring and unsaturated. So it is INE. We will remove this A as per the second rule and the name will be azine. Now coming to this example, so here it contains nitrogen and it contains partially unsaturation. Now here we have to first do the numbering for this ring. So either we go in this direction or we will go in this direction. So just opposite to other nomenclature system, here first we will take the saturated atoms. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. If we will go in this direction, then saturated atom will get the numbering of 1, 3 and 2. But in this direction, it is getting 2, 3 and 6. So this is a better way. Now first we will write this one. It contains 3 saturated atoms. So first we will mention their position, that is 2, 3 and 6. So it will be 2, 3 and 6. And we will use the word trihydro. Now coming to the same nomenclature. So aza is the prefix and a 6 membered ring and unsaturated, it will be in, INE. So we will remove this A and the complete name will be 236 trihydroazine. Here one special point arises, and according to that, if unsaturation is present and saturation is also present, in that case we have to give the priority to the saturated atoms. So these are the IUPAC name for these examples. Now let's take some more examples for better understanding. So coming to the first structure, so it contains nitrogen, so prefix will be aza. Now coming to the suffix or root word, so for saturated nitrogen containing compound with 5 membered ring, so it will be olidine. So we will remove this A and the complete name will be azolidine. Now coming to this structure, so it is thia. Now coming to the root word, and it is a 5 membered ring, so it will be olane. So we will remove this A and complete name will be thiolane. Now coming to this example, so it contains oxygen and the prefix will be oxa, and the suffix or root word will be again olane. So here also we will remove A and complete name will be oxolane. Now coming to this example, so here prefix is phosphor. Now coming to the root word, so it will be again olane. We will remove this A and complete name will be phospholane. So these are some basics of IUPAC nomenclature. Now you can take a screenshot of this board, then we will further proceed for some more examples, more complex examples. Now let's proceed for the next rule. So as per this statement, if substituent is present, then hetero atom is designated number one. Always we will give number one position to the hetero atom, and the substituent around the chain are numbered so as to have the lowest numbering position. Means we will number in such a way that that substituent will get the lowest number. So let's take few examples for better understanding of this rule. So as per this rule, we have to start numbering from the hetero atom. So here it will be 1, 1 and 1. Now coming to the next statement, substituent around the chain are numbered so as to have the lowest numbering position. If we will go through this side, then it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So in second position, we are getting ethyl group. If we will go in this direction, then it will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. In fourth position, we are getting ethyl group. So this is the correct numbering system. Similarly, in this example, if we will go in this direction, then it will be 1, 2, 3. So in second position, we are having chlorine. And if we will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3. In third position, we will get chlorine. So this is the correct numbering system. Similarly, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in second and third position, we are getting substituents. If we will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in fourth and fifth position, we are getting the substituent. Now coming to the nomenclature of this compound. So as you can see here, it contains oxygen, and in second position it contains ethyl. So first we will write 2-ethyl, then it contains oxa. Then coming to the root word, so here you can see that it is a 4-membered ring and it is saturated. So 4-membered ring and saturated, so it is etane. So we will remove this A and a complete name will be 2-ethyl oxetane. Now coming to this example, so here in second position chlorine is present, so it will be 2-chloro, and it contains sulfur, and the prefix for sulfur is thia, so it will be thia. And it is a 3-membered ring and saturated. So 3-membered ring, saturated irane, I-R-A-N-E. We will remove this A and complete name will be 2-chlorothirane, T-H-I-I-R-A-N-E. Now coming to this compound. So here it contains bromine in second position and methyl in third position. So as per the alphabetical, bromo will come first as compared to methyl. So we will write 2-bromo-3-methyl, and it contains phosphorus. So a prefix is phospha, P-H-O-S-P-H-A, and it is a 5-membered ring and saturated. So it is olein. So we will remove this A and the complete name will be 2-bromo-3-methyl-phospholane. So these are some examples which will support this rule. Now coming to the sixth rule. So as per this statement, if partially unsaturation is present, then give preference to the saturated atoms during numbering. It is same thing. And use the root word of unsaturated compound. So for better understanding of this rule, let's take few examples. So these are the examples, and as per this rule, let's start the numbering. So we will start with these heteroatoms 1, 1, 1. Now coming to this statement. So if partially unsaturation is present, then give preference to the saturated atoms. So here, if we will go in this direction, then here unsaturated atoms are present. So we will choose this direction. So it will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In second and third position, unsaturated atoms are present. And similarly, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In this direction, saturated atoms are present. Similarly, here 1, 2, 3, and 4. In this direction, saturated atoms are present. Now coming to this compound, so in second and third position, saturated atoms are present, so it will be 2,3-dihydro, and it contains nitrogen, so it will be aza, and it is a 7-membered ring, and we have to choose for unsaturated 7-membered unsaturated epine. E-P-I-N-E. So complete name will be 2,3-dihydroazepine. We will remove A and it will be 2,3-dihydroazepine. Now coming to this example. So it contains one methyl group in fifth position. So first we will write 5-methyl. Now in second, third, fourth and fifth position, saturated atoms are present, so it will be 2,3,4,5-tetrahydro. Now coming to the prefix, so prefix will be oxa. And coming to the root word, so for 7-membered ring and unsaturated, it is epine. E-P-I-N-E. So here we will remove this A and it will be 5-methyl-2,3,4,5-tetrahydro-oxapine. Here we will remove this one. So it will be 5-methyl-2,3,4,5-tetrahydroxapine. Now coming to this structure. So second atom is unsaturated. So we will write 2-hydro or we will write 2-monohydro. Prefix will be thia, T-H-I-A, and it is a 4-membered ring. So 4-membered ring and unsaturated it, E-T-E. So complete name will be, we will remove this A, so complete name will be 2-monohydrothiate. Sometimes it is also called as 2-hydrothiate. So these are few rules regarding Hans-Widman nomenclature. Now you can take a screenshot of this board. After that I will discuss some more examples. Now coming to the rules for those rings which contains more than one heteroatoms. So this rule is for those heterocyclic compounds which are having more than one heteroatoms. So two or more similar atoms contained in a ring are indicated by the prefixes di, tri, tetra, etc. So let's take few examples for better understanding of this rule. So these are few examples for better understanding this rule. So if you are going through this example, so it contains 3 nitrogen atoms. So from any of the nitrogen atom, we can start numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have started from this nitrogen, then in first, third and fifth position nitrogen is present. If we will start from this position to this direction, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 3 and 5 again. If we will start with this nitrogen in any direction, so in all direction it will be same. Now coming to the nomenclature of this particular compound. So as per this rule, we have to write the position. So it will be 1, 3 and 5. Then we will use tri. Now coming to the prefix. So for nitrogen, it is aza. Now coming to the root word. So it is unsaturated compound, unsaturated 5-6 membered. So in, INE. So we will remove this A and the complete name will be 1,3,5-triazine. Now coming to this example. So in this example, if we will start from here, then it will be 1,2,3,4,5. So in first position, second position and the fourth position nitrogen is present. If we will go in this direction, then 1,2,3. So this direction is rejected because 1,3 and 5 position will be appearing. So 1,2,4, it contains 3 nitrogen, so it will be tri. Now coming to the prefix. So for nitrogen, it is aza, and it is 5 membered unsaturated ring, so it will be ol. O-L-E, we will remove this A and the complete name will be 1,2,4-triazole. Now coming to this structure, so it contains 2 nitrogen atom, so either we will start from this nitrogen or from this nitrogen. If we will start from this nitrogen, then we will go in this direction only because here hetero atom is present. So 1,2,3,4 and in 5th and 6th position saturated atoms are present. But if we will start with this nitrogen, then 1,2,3,4,5,6 in 4 and 5 positions saturated atoms are present, and if we have to follow this rule also. So this is the correct numbering system. So first we will write 4,5-dihydro. Now coming to the nitrogen position, so it will be 1,2-di. And the prefix is aza, and it is a 6-membered ring unsaturated in, INE. So we will remove this A and the complete name will be 4,5-dihydro-1,2-diazine. So these are the IUPAC nomenclature for these compounds as per this rule. Now coming to the second rule under more than one heteroatoms. So as per this statement, if more than one hetero atom is present, then use the prefixes of all in given order. For example, here it is nitrogen, here it may be phosphorus. Then we have to use the prefixes of nitrogen as well as phosphorus. And the preference will be this one, oxygen, then sulfur, then nitrogen, then phosphorus. This is the priority order. Now let's take few examples for better understanding of this rule. So as per this preference order, we will start numbering from here. It is 1,2,3,4. So first we will write 1,2. Now as per the preference order, we have to choose the prefix. So first we will choose ox for oxygen, then we have to choose for nitrogen, and for saturated nitrogen containing compounds, we have to take this one, etidine. So complete name will be, here we will remove this A, and the complete name will be 1,2-oxetidine. Now coming to this example, so here nitrogen is present, here sulfur is present, and for example here one double bond is present, and here also double bond is present. Now coming to the numbering, so as per this priority order, we will start numbering with sulfur and we will go in this direction, so it will be 1,2,3,4,5. So coming to the nomenclature, so in 1 and 3rd position sulfur and nitrogen is present, so it will be 1,3. Now as per the priority order, first we will take the prefix of sulfur, so it is thia. Now coming to the prefix for nitrogen, so it is aza because it is unsaturated ring, so it will be aza. Now coming to the root word, so it is a 5-membered unsaturated ring, so it will be ol. OLE. So complete name will be 1-3. This A will be removed and it will be thiazole. This A will also be removed. So this will be the complete name for this structure, 1-3-thiazole. Now coming to this example, so it will be like this. It contains sulfur, it contains nitrogen, it again contains sulfur. Here one double bond is present and here one double bond is present. Now here first we have to start numbering. So if we are starting from this position, so either we will go in this direction or in this direction. So if we will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3, 4, in four position another sulfur is present. If we will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3, and 4, again fourth position. But if we will go in this direction, then advantage is that in second position we are getting nitrogen, and in this direction we will get, in sixth position we will get nitrogen. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now coming to the IUPAC nomenclature for this particular system, so it will be 1-4, because here sulfur is preferred over nitrogen. Then coming to the position of nitrogen, so it will be 2. Now coming to the prefix for sulfur, so it will be thia, so it will be dithia. Now coming to the prefix for nitrogen, so it will be aza, and it is six membered ring and unsaturated, so it will be ine. Now here we will remove this A and this A, and we can write the complete name of this structure. So it will be 1,4-2-dithiazine. So these are the IUPAC nomenclature for these examples, and these are the complete details about Hans-Widman nomenclature. Now I will discuss about common names, so you can take a screenshot of this board. Then in this video only I will discuss the common names and the replacement nomenclature system. Now in this section I will discuss the details about those heterocyclic compounds which are mainly or widely known by their common names or non-systematic names. So let's take few of them as an example. So common name for this structure is furan. Now coming to the second example. So common name for this structure is thiophene. Now coming to the third example. Common name for this structure is pyrrole. Now coming to the fourth example. So common name for this structure is pyridine. Now coming to the fifth example. So this structure is known as pyridazine. Now coming to the next example. So common name for this structure is indole. Now coming to the next example. So common name for this example is quinoline. If this nitrogen atom will be here in the place of this one, then it will be known as isoquinoline. Now coming to the next example. So common name for this structure is coumarin. So as per this rule, common names of some heterocyclic compounds are used. These are the example of those common names. Now coming to the second rule. So as per this rule, identical systems connected by a single bond, then use the prefixes bi, ter, quarter, etc. according to the number of systems and bonding is indicated. So for better understanding this rule, let's take few examples. So both are identical system and both are pyridine and it is connected by a single bond. So we have to do the numbering for both the atoms. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And for this ring also we have to do the numbering, that is here we will start with 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash and 6 dash. So as per this statement we have to do the nomenclature for this structure, and here both the rings are attached in 2 and 2 dash position, so we will write 2, 2 dash, and both the rings are pyridine, so it will be bipyridine. So this will be the IUPAC name for this structure as per this common name nomenclature system. Now coming to the second example. So it contains three ring system. So first we have to do the nomenclature for this ring. So we will start with heteroatom 1. Now we will go in this direction because in this direction it is attached with another ring. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now coming to this structure. So we will start with this. It will be 1 dash. Then here it will be 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash. Now coming to this ring. So we will start with this one, 1 double dash. If you will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3, in third position we are getting this attachment, and if we will go in this direction, then 1, 2, 3, 4, in fourth position we are getting this attachment. So it will be 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 double dash, sorry it is double dash, 4 double dash and 5 double dash. So this is the complete numbering of this system. Now coming to the first, these two rings, so it will be 2, 2 dash. Now coming to the second and third ring, and we have to use this ratio. So it will be 4 dash, 3 double dash. So it will be 4 dash, 3 double dash. It contains three ring, so we will use ter. And this is the structure of thiophene. So it will be thiophene. So complete name will be 2, 2 dash ratio 4, 4 dash, 3 double dash, ter thiophene. So these are the examples related to this rule. Now coming to the next rule where fused rings are present. So as per this rule, side of the heterocyclic ring is labeled by A, B, C, D, E, F and so on. For example, if we are writing A, it means it indicates the atoms between 1 and 2. Similarly, if B is present, it indicates between atoms 2 and 3. So for better understanding of this rule, let's take few examples. So these are the examples, and here you can see that this is a heteroatom. So this bond will be named as A, this bond will be named as B, and here this is a heteroatom. So if we will go in this direction, then A, B and C, and if we will go in this direction, then also A, B and C. So we can take any direction, it will be A and it will be B and it will be C. Now coming to the nomenclature. So for this structure we will use bench. Now we will give the position, that is B, that is fused ring system. So in B bond it is fused, bench B, and this structure is known as furan. So complete name will be bench B furan. Now coming to this structure, so here you can see that in C position it is present, fusion is present in C position, so it will be bench C, and this is the structure of thiophene. So it will be bench C thiophene. So these are the nomenclature for these examples. Now coming to the next rule, that is handling of extra hydrogens. So this rule is for handling of the extra hydrogen atoms. And the heterocycles with maximum number of double bonds can be arranged in more than one way. For better understanding of this rule, let's take few examples. So in this example, we will start numbering with hetero atom, and as per the rule, first we will choose or give the preference to the saturated atom. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now coming to the nomenclature. So for nomenclature of this compound, first we will write 2, then in italics we will write H, because in second atom extra hydrogens are present, and this structure is known as pyrone. So complete name of this structure is 2H pyrone. Similarly here, we will start numbering from here. Now here we can go in this direction also, in this direction also. In both the direction we will get this extra hydrogen in fourth position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be 4. In italics, it will be 4. In italics, we will write H. Then it is again pyrone. Now let's take some more examples. So in these examples, let's start the numbering. So here it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here it will be 1. Now we will go in this direction. So it will be 2, 3, 4, and 5. And here it will be 1. Now if we will go in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, in fourth position, these two extra hydrogens are present. So we will go in this direction. So here in third position, it will be present. 4, 5. Now coming to the nomenclature. So here in first position, extra hydrogen is present. So it will be 1H pyrrole. Now coming to this example. So here in second position, it is present. So it will be 2H pyrrole. And here it is present in third position. So it will be 3H pyrrole. So in this type of extra hydrogen, we have to add 1H, 2H, 3H, and so on. And this number indicates position of extra hydrogen. Add 1H, 2H, 3H, etc. as a prefix. And the number indicates position of the extra hydrogen. So this is the complete detail about common names nomenclature system. Now in this video only, I will discuss about replacement nomenclature system. So you can take a screenshot of this board, then we will start that video. So this is the third type of nomenclature, that is replacement nomenclature. So coming to the rule for replacement nomenclature. So as per this statement, the heterocycle's name is composed of carbocycle's name and a prefix that denotes the heteroatom. Means we will use the prefix of heteroatom, then we will use the name of carbocycles, means cyclohexane, cyclopentane, etc. So coming to the name of or prefixes of heteroatoms, which I have already discussed in the starting part of this video. So first heteroatom is oxygen, and the prefix for oxygen is oxa. Second heteroatom is sulfur, and the prefix is thia. Third heteroatom is nitrogen, and the prefix is aza. Fourth heteroatom is phosphorus, and the prefix is phosphor. Now coming to the second rule for this replacement nomenclature. So as per this statement, notice that heterocyclic rings are numbered in such a way so that the hetero atom has the lowest possible numbering. Now let's take few examples for better understanding this nomenclature. So these are few examples. Now coming to this example, so here only nitrogen is present and there is no double bond or any substituent is present, so there is no need of numbering. If we will do numbering, then we can write like this 1 2 3 or 1 2 3. Now coming to the name, so first we will take the prefix, that is aza, because nitrogen is present, so we will write aza. Now coming to the carbocycle name, so it is a cyclopropane, so we will write cyclopropane. So complete name for this structure will be aza cyclopropane. Now coming to the second example, so here prefix is oxa for oxygen. If we want to do the numbering, then it will be 1 2 3 4, otherwise no need of numbering. And it is a cyclobutane, so we will write oxacyclobutane. Now coming to this structure, so here one substituent is present, so we will do the numbering. So we will start with hetero atom. Now we can go in this direction or in this direction. So if we will go in this direction, then 1 2 3 4 5 in fifth position substituent will be present, but if we will go in this direction, then in second position substituent will be present. So 1 2 3 4 5, so first we will write this one, that is 2-methyl. Now coming to the prefix for nitrogen, so it is aza. Now coming to the number of atoms present in this ring, so total 5 atoms are present, so it will be cyclopentane. So complete name will be 3-methyl aza cyclopentane. Now coming to this structure, so we will start numbering from here, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. So here you can see that in second position and in third position substituents are present, and this is methyl group, this is ethyl group. So first we will take ethyl as per the alphabetic order, so it will be 2-ethyl 3-methyl. Now coming to the prefix, so it will be aza, and it contains 6 atoms, so it will be cyclohexane. So complete name will be 2-ethyl 3-methyl aza cyclohexane. Now coming to this structure, so here we will start numbering from this carbon, this nitrogen. Now here one substituent is also present and one double bond is also present, so in that case we have to give preference to these double bonds, so it will be 2 3 4 5 and 6. Now we will write the name, so first we will write 5-methyl. Now coming to the prefix, that is aza. Now coming to this structure, so it contains 6 atoms, so it will be cyclohexane, so first we will write cyclohex, and in second position one double bond is present, so it will be 2 and it will be in. So complete name will be 5-methyl aza cyclohex 2-in. So this is the complete details about IUPAC nomenclature for heterocyclic compound. Here all nomenclature are completed. Thank you.